Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from TechFanciers. In this video, we will see how to install the Oxygen OS 11 Android 11 on MIA2. So as per our last MIA2 video, we have reverted back to stock Android, and you can see I am currently in stock Android 10 with unlocked bootloader. From here, we'll start the installation. So there are few good change logs, like it has 4.4+, camera kernel, CTS passes by default, unlimited Google Photo backups. The procedures are same as installing any other ports. Before starting, I have to thank Alok Raj for making this port. Currently, I do not have TWRP installed, so for that I will enable USB debugging. And reboot to the bootloader using ADB fast boot tool. Once in fast boot tool, let me boot the TWRP image using fast boot boot and drag and drop the TWRP image file and hit enter. Now we have booted to TWRP. I will just format the data and wipe the partitions as it is fully encrypted. So warning, I already have backed up all the data. Formatting ROM is dangerous and it will erase all your data. So do it at your own risk. Once done, I will reboot to fastboot and boot again to TWRP. Once back, we'll copy the TWRP installer to our mobile and install. Now we have successfully installed the TWRP, I will now copy the OxygenOS port zip to my mobile. The installation is simple and it just installs the act in the active partition, so you no need to swap the slot after installing the port. It takes like 2.5 minutes, so please be patient. Once the installation is over, let me just wipe the cache and Dalvik. Reboot to system. So the first boot will take like nearly 5 to 10 minutes, so you can have a coffee or something and come. Okay, now we have successfully installed the port. I already have backed up my data in Google One, so let me just log in and restore my last backup. Finally, all FRP is done. Thank you. The UI looks bit slow or lag, has some latency, but I assume it is because of the restoring in the background and this live wallpaper. Audio is working fine. Camera, we have OnePlus own camera app and Google Camera Go. Not sure how it performs. We'll check those and make it in a review. It is currently running December 2021 security patch, 7 to 8 months old. That is fine. Fingerprint is working fine. Let me restart and check the boot time. Okay, now it takes around 30 seconds. Hope it will reduce. So that's what about this video. I will be using this for my upcoming days and provide you with the status. If I found any major issue or bug, I will make sure to update in the pinned comment of this video. So thank you for watching. Code Moto.